I would like now to illustrate these sampling strategies on a concrete example. And I will use again this transportation mode choice example with three alternatives and three categories for the exogenous variable. And now I will assume that I know the full population. So I have a population of 1 million individuals, and they are distributed across the cells like it is described in this contingency table. Okay, so there are 300,000 people who drive alone for a trip which is less than 15 minutes. There are 10,000 people who do carpooling for a trip which is more than 30 minutes, and so on. So we can, from these values, we can calculate the row and the column totals. So here I have 500K. Here I have 300K. Here I have 200K. And here I have 520K. 150K. And 330K. And the total is 1,000K. So this is fine. I can also look at the shares. So 500K out of 1,000K, so this is 50%. 30%. 20%. And I can do it for the market shares of the modes. I have 52% here. 15% and 33%. Now let's assume I apply a simple random sampling. Okay, so remember I need four parameters to calculate the R, the selection probability. So here I know the population size is 1 million. And let's say I would like a sample of 1,000 individuals. In the context of simple random sampling, I have only one stratum, meaning that WG and HG are equal to 1. So I can calculate R, in this case R, which is constant for all individuals in the population, is equal to HG times NS divided by WG times N, which is equal to 1,000 divided by 1 million. So this is equal to 1 over 1,000. Okay, so the probability for each individual to be selected in the sample is 1 divided by 1,000. And this is summarized in this table. So here, whatever the cell, the probability to be selected is the same. So this is the characteristic of a simple random sampling strategy. Okay, so let's do the sampling. So on the top, I have the population, and on the bottom, I will constitute my sample. So basically here, it's simple because I sample one individual out of 1,000. So somehow I will copy the top table without the K at the bottom, in the bottom table. Same for the totals. So I have 1,500, 300, 200, 520, 150, 330. And I have a total of 1,000 individuals in my sample. And now if you calculate the shares, well, you recover the exact same shares as the population. So this is basically the property of this simple random sampling, is that it replicates exactly the statistical properties of the population. As we discussed at length, this is mathematically convenient, but not feasible in practice. Let's now illustrate the exogenous sampling strategy. So again, we have a population of 1 million individuals. We would like to get a sample of 1,000. And here, we define three strata based on travel time. In this context, we know the Ws, right? The Ws are given by the shares in the population. So in this case, we have 50% of people with a short travel time, 30% of people with a medium travel time, and 20% of people with a long travel time. And now we have to design the sample. In the sample, we would like each of these categories to be equally present. So we would like that 1/3 of the sample is in category 1, short travel time, 1/3 is in the medium travel time, and 1/3 would be in the long travel time. Good, so now we can calculate the R. So what is the probability for the first stratum, for individual in the first stratum, to be in the sample? So again, it's H1NS divided by W1N, which would be H1 is 1/3, NS is 1,000, W1 is 1/2, and the total population is 1 million. So in total, we have 1 divided by 1,500. Similarly, we can calculate the probability for people in the second group, the medium travel time. It's H2NS divided by W2N, which is equal to, well, again, 1/3 times 1,000 for the numerator, and we have 0.3 times 1 million at the denominator. So we have a total of 1 divided by 900 for the probability in the second group. And for the last one, it is H3NS divided by W3N. This is equal to 1/3 times 1,000 divided by 0.2 times 1 million. And we obtain a probability of 1 over 600. So if we put these probabilities in the table, this is what we have. So for people who have a short travel time, the probability to be selected in the sample is 1 over 1500, and it's the same irrespectively of the choice they make, which is important. Remember, this is exogenous. For people who have a medium travel time, the probability to be selected in the sample is 1 over 900, and for the long travel time is 1 over 600. And again, these quantities are constant, irrespectively of the choice people make. Good, we can now apply the sampling strategy and collect data, right? So that's what we will do using the proportions that we have seen in the previous slide. So what we obtain is 200 people here, 33.3, 100, 166.7, 100, 116.7, 16.7, and 200. And now we can calculate the totals. Well, here we have one third, one third, one third. So this is by design. Remember, we decided that each group should be equally represented in the sample. And now here we have if we calculate the shares, we have 33.3, so which is 1/3, 1/3, 1/3. So this is by design. And here we have 48.3%, 15%, and 36.7%. As you can see, the statistical properties of the sample do not reflect the statistical properties of the population. So first, these do not reflect these, but this is by design. This is something I decided. But you have to realize as well that even the market shares do not correspond to the population. And this is important to keep in mind. So although the strategy is called exogenous, it does not involve the choice variable. It does not mean that the market shares of the alternatives will be the same in the sample as in the population. Actually, they are not, because the I and the X are correlated, right? We assume causality. So if you modify the X's, you will also modify the I's. And this is something that you observed here. So an exogenous strategy does not necessarily, and usually does not, reflect the actual market shares in the population. Let's now illustrate a choice-based sampling strategy. Again, I have my population of 1 million, I have a sample of 1,000, and here I would like to define my strata based on the mode of transportation. I know that in the population, the market shares are 52, 15, and 33. And I would like that my sample has the equal share of each of them, one third, one third, one third. So again, I can calculate the probability for an individual of each group to be selected in the sample. R1 would be H1 and S divided by W1N, which would be 1/3 times 1,000. This is my design variable. And here I have 0.52 times 1 million. So this is something like 1 divided by 1560. R2 would be H2 and S divided by W2N, which is 1/3 1,000 divided by 0.15 times 1 million. So it would make 1 over 450. And then R3 would be H3 and S divided by W3N. This would be 1/3 1,000 divided by 0.33 times 1 million. And this would be 1 divided by 990. If you report these values in the table, what you observe is that the selection probability is different from each cell, but this is constant across each column because it's a pure choice-based sampling. And now we can perform the sampling itself. So we multiply the value of the populations by the ratio that we have derived in the previous slide, and we obtain the following value. So 192.3. We can now calculate the totals. So here we have the same number of individuals in each category. This is by design. And again, this means 1/3, 1/3, 1/3. And here we have 45.5%. We have 35.7%, and we have 18.8%. Again, we realize that the statistical properties of the sample do not match the statistical properties of the population. Of course, here we have 1/3, 1/3, 1/3, which does not reflect the true market shares, but this is by design. We decided to do this. And again, as we discussed in the previous example, although the strategy was only based on the choice, not on the exogenous variable, the shares of the exogenous variables do not match the shares in the population.